Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to our e-learning platform of Eduom Scientific e-learning platform. I hope you all are doing great. Let's begin our today's session. This will be a practical guide to NCBR for the beginner participant and the learner. This session will have a brief introduction and overview about NCBR with practical demonstration of NCBI subset. NCBI stands for National Center of Biotechnology Information, which is a part of United States National Library of Medicine, a branch of National Institute of Health, NIH. So those who are new to this platform, you are requested to use this URL to come to this platform. The platform are run and managed by different kind of manpower from scientific community, having a diverse experience from various subsets like clinicians, researchers, professor, journalist, grant writer, biocurator, and other health sector professionals. Let's discuss who and why and what kind of people will require such data and information. What are the most searched program and subset are here? Like most frequently we use NCBI PubMed, which is a publication of medicine. We get scientific literatures and information from this subset. NCBI Gene, NCBI Protein, NCBI PubChem, BLAST, NCBI Genome, and so on. We will show you some of the live sources and demonstration of few sub-platform here, like for searching and retrieval of scientific publication via NCBI PubMed. It is not possible to show each and individual dropdown in one video, but in our upcoming videos, we will be providing you all such learning experience with a practical demonstration. So in NCBI, those who are beginners can use different kind of research. They can collect the biological and scientific data from this platform. You can go to this all databases in this left session. And from this drop-down, you can get gene, genome, PubChem, protein, variant, taxonomy, different kind of biological data. So you can use, you can type your whatever search you want to run, type in this section, and this will provide you scientific validated information. So one of the subset of NCBI, which we mostly utilize in our scientific biomedical area, is your NCBI PubMed. So let's start with research article search first. PubMed provides biomedical scientific literature from life sciences, journals, and also from books. These include full text content from PubMed Central and also from the publisher websites. PubMed is a modern hub with a fast, reliable, scientific and intuitive search platform, providing biomedical and scientific data to the global biomedical field. So briefly, we get high quality data for our projects in a fast and reliable way. Why we need these kind of data? So suppose you are doing certain project, thesis, or might be you are writing your articles, or if you are a student, you want to understand a particular areas, how people are working on those subject areas, then you can do search from literature search from PubMed. You have to type your whatever search you are doing. For example, if I have to search about scientific literature about breast cancer, I have to type here. If you want to go for basic search, you can just click on the search button. But if you want to minimize your search things, then you can also use advanced settings. You can either use advanced settings and change your, you can get your best match. You can change the dates. If you want a particular journal, then you can get a particular journal related articles, or you can either get the information via author name also. Okay, so let's begin with the demo. So this is the NCBI page. You have to go to this page and you have to go to this left side. You have to go to this drop down And suppose if you have to find out any research article, we have to go to this PubMed, okay? And suppose if I have to read about breast cancer, CRISPR, aptamer, cancer, nanotechnology, biopharmaceutical, you just have to type this name in search here. This is for basic search. I will be teaching you advanced search mechanisms and the ways how you can get it in a advanced setting in the upcoming videos. But for the basic search, you can type it out your search in a keywords like whatever you want to learn. And you can get, see, breast cancer is a very significant area. So we are getting a huge amount of articles, research articles, both reviews, research articles, and all these things. It is date-wise mentioned here. But if you want to minimize or you want a limited significant literature, then you can either go to this display setting and change your settings depending on your needs. Or maybe you can go to the advanced areas also. Here also, you can minimize your search. So this advanced setting things, we will demonstrate in the upcoming video. But for beginner level, you can get your information, scientific literature from this kind of basic search platform and engine. If you want to read this article, you just have to click this papers. You will be taken to this article page. And if you want the full article of, this is the like citations, which journals, which date this paper has been published. Everything is mentioned here along with the abstract. If you want the full article of this paper, then you have to go to this, the journal site, okay? Some articles will require money. We have to pay. And if your library has already the subscription from your institute, then you will get the full PDF from the paper. Otherwise, we have to do the signups and login and we have to pay for the papers. So you can get the PDF file here. I think they are charging for the article. So we have to pay here. Otherwise, you have to see, depending on your institute, you can get the article freely also. So this is one of the paper related to RNA biology. And here you are getting all this paper information. So here, this is the PDF file. And from here, you can get this full paper and utilize this for your scientific work. Okay, so this is a basic search platform from where you can get it, the scientific literature. Obviously, if suppose you have to work on cancer, breast cancer, and areas like that, you won't go through each 4 lakhs or 5 lakh of paper. Then we have to minimize those search results in a significant way. For that, we require advanced kind of search platform that I will show you in the upcoming video. Okay. So if you are liking the videos, please do subscribe our channel and provide your feedback and also your comments. We are looking forward to them. Please share these videos among your scientific endeavor. Thank you so much.